Hey friends, welcome back. Today, I put a challenge to myself to try and figure out the exact steps that I would take if I was starting with zero knowledge into cybersecurity. And I had 6 months to do it. And I think I managed a pretty solid approach in this video. So if you're new or you're thinking about switching careers, definitely keep watching. Hi everyone, I'm Venetia. I'm a cloud security architect and I'm a Microsoft MVP. I have been working in cybersecurity for a while and I love helping you along this journey by sharing everything that I know to make it simpler for you. But if I were to start at zero with no certs and no experience, I think that this is exactly how I would tackle it in 2025. Now, these are only 7 steps that would take me approximately 6 months with a laser-focused calendar. So if this is what you're interested in, definitely join the community, subscribe, check out all the links below. I always have some cool roadmaps, some cool information. So let's get into this. All right. Firstly, let's briefly talk about data brokers. Now, basically, these companies collect every scrap of your personal information. So think social media profiles, public records, online purchases, the random surveys that you filled out ages ago. They then bundle it all up together to sell to advertisers, marketers, or even other data brokers. It's kind of wild if you think about it. Like, the stuff that you casually shared here and there online is now floating around in huge databases without you ever knowing about it. I remember wanting to remove my data from these sites myself, like going through each data broker's website, then combing through forms, sending emails, requesting takedowns. I mean, like you can probably imagine, it's an endless task. And seriously, by the time you remove yourself from the one site, you discover that there's 3 more listings with your information. That's why I am super pumped again to be partnering with Delete Me. Their service finds these data broker sites, finds your personal details, and then submits removal requests for you. So you're not stuck playing whack-a-mole with 100 different companies. They send you quarterly reports on how much data they found and were able to take down, which is really comforting. I find it super comforting to know, you know, that they follow up and they make sure that my personal data really does stay private and they remove it wherever they are able to. So if you are fed up with the random spam texts, calls, ads, do yourself a favor and check out joindeleteme.com/cyberqueen. Use my code cyberqueen for 20% off. Check it out, friends, and thank me later. All right, without any further delays, we are going to start with step one. Step one is going to be the absolute foundation. And here I would start with cybrary. So the first step is to build a rock solid space and ground to start off. So if I'm brand new, like I mean nothing, no technology, no security, nothing, I would start with cybrary's intro to IT and cybersecurity. So this is a great way to get an understanding of the lay of the land. You'll learn the basics of operating systems, network, security concepts, and more all in one place. So this is beginner friendly, and the best part is you can finish it on your own time and it's free. So if you complete it and then you realize that cybersecurity is absolutely not for you, then you've wasted less than 2 hours and no money. So that's where I'd start to make sure, absolutely sure, that I want this. This is for me. I'm here for the journey. I'm getting into it. Now, the next step here is going to be the Google Cybersecurity Professional Certificate. And there's a reason why I went with this certificate program over some of the kind of foundational certifications out there. I do, by the way, have a video comparing the Google Cybersecurity Certificate with Security Plus. I have a full complete video in the channel if you want to check that out after this one. But this is really a comprehensive course that dives into deeper security tools, network defense, and incident response. What I love about it is that it's a pay by the month subscriber platform model. So if you're like super motivated, you could really spend the time and energy and knock it out quickly. Plus, I mean, it's Google. So there's some Google name recognition there. It doesn't hurt on your resume. And it shows employers that you've covered some real world practical security concepts. In my view, the course is really gaining traction in the industry right now. and it would be worth it for considering the cost of the course itself versus the knowledge that you'll learn and the insights that you'll gain from actual industry experts, because industry professionals are who wrote this course, and that's why I think it resonates with so many people and it's starting to resonate with so many employers out there. Now, step three, here is where a lot of people would go for Security Plus, which is great. Don't get me wrong, I like Security Plus, but it doesn't offer any hands-on skills, and I am not in the US, so I'm not targeting any DoD list of credentials. So I am a huge advocate for practical experience, and this is why I would personally grab OffSec's SEC 100. Now, this is designed to give you real practical lab work. So you're not just memorizing multiple choice answers, but you're actually doing the things that a cybersecurity professional would do. Like, you're getting that experience. So it really sets you apart when it comes to the stage of like answering questions and getting you through the interview process. So the SEC 100 is foundation level. It's provided by OffSec, which is the organization behind the OSCP, which is very well known in the cybersecurity industry. You will learn some Windows and Linux fundamentals. You will learn how to do some basic vulnerability identification. You'll do problem solving using real world hacking methodologies. Think of it like a mini bootcamp for offensive security. It's a perfect stepping stone. If you also in the future want to explore more advanced OffSec courses, then this would be a great place to start. Or if you just want to go into blue teaming and security analysis, incident response, the SOC, this is a really good place to start and kind of learn theory but get practical hands-on skills as well. Now, friends, this course is a pricey one. You are gonna pay for it, and it is pricey. So at this point, you have to be invested and you have to make sure that you actually want a job in this industry, and then you pay the money to invest in your education in the industry. But in my view, the SEC 100 is absolutely worth it. I did the training last year on the SEC 100. I actually did a full course review for them together with OffSec, gave my input into the course. And I think this one is really good. It's really comprehensive. It's absolutely so worth spending the money on this training and education for SEC 100. Now, we are at step four. Step four is networking knowledge. Now here, I would get networking knowledge with the Cisco Networking Academy. Networking is the backbone of everything in IT. I would get into the Cisco Networking Academy programs. So they offer courses on basic networking concepts like subnetting, routing, switching, hands-on simulations with Cisco Packet Tracer. And there's clear pathways if you wanna get into the direction towards CCNA, or if you just wanna learn networking, get skills so that you can put this on your resume. So you guys, being comfortable with networking basics is gonna help you with a lot of things. It's not only about how data flows, but it also makes diagnosing security issues that much easier. I've spoken about networking a ton. Like, most of my guests that I have on my podcast speak about networking. It really is that step that you don't skimp over. So I would probably spend the bulk of my time on my journey learning about networking, if I'm honest. I would actually not do the Network Plus, but I would go the Cisco route for networking knowledge. It's just like Cisco is that company, you know, like, yeah, I understand they do a lot more, but networking Cisco, like, okay, that's just in my mind. This is what I would do. Okay. All right. Step five is going to be cloud security. Now, cloud security is a non-negotiable in modern cybersecurity. Coming from a very biased cloud security architect, I would say. But if I was starting today, I promise you, I would be targeting cloud specifically. So whether it's in a startup or a massive enterprise, cloud is everywhere and it needs securing. So here's how I would then build my cloud fundamental skills. So firstly, there is the AZ 900 and there is the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner. Now, both of these certs are beginner friendly. They cover some core services, some basic security features, and the shared responsibility model concept, which breaks down who handles what in the cloud, right? But if on my journey, in order to, you know, specialize and to make sure that I'm employable in the quickest time possible with capitalizing on how I'm targeting this industry in under 6 months, I'm gonna choose a provider of choice. And in my case, I'm gonna choose Azure. So the options are there for a cloud practitioner and AZ 900, but I would be focusing on AZ 900. If you want to target AWS, you should be focusing on the cloud practitioner, right? AWS. Like, if you want to target GCP, you go for the same setup and structure here, but you target GCP. So I would focus in on the AZ-900, the Azure Fundamentals, and the SC-200, so the Security Operations Certification. And a couple of reasons here is because I want to learn core cloud concepts. So I want to learn about virtual machines, storage accounts, networking, and kind of the basics of Azure. So then also the security basics, so identity and access management, role-based access control. And then the AZ-900 is also going to give you some of the core understanding of platform and cost structures and services and any kind of SLAs that goes with the platform. So it's going to give you kind of that well-rounded understanding for cloud computing as a whole. And then you're going to bolster with security, right? So you're going to start with cloud computing as a whole, bolster with security. So in this case, you're going to learn about monitoring and detection tools with Microsoft Defender for Cloud. With the SC200, you're going to be able to learn about how to identify vulnerabilities and misconfigurations or weak IAM policies. You're going to be able to learn about and ideally play with Defender for Cloud and Microsoft Sentinel. Incident response in the cloud context is really, really big. So knowing like where the logs live and how to investigate suspicious activity is going to be crucial on your journey towards learning and understanding about cloud computing specifically. So of course, a natural progression here would be to look into more advanced certs like the Azure Security Engineer AZ-500 or the AWS Certified Security Specialty, but I wouldn't focus on this in this 6-month plan. Like, I would look to AZ-500 as a next step, but not in this specific plan. It would be a little bit too advanced and require a little bit more advanced skills, which I wouldn't have in the first 6 months at all. Step 6, we're gonna build the portfolio. Here is where certs look good on paper. We've got them now, they look great. But real world projects is what proves that you can actually walk the talk, okay? So this is how I would do it. So firstly, with Cloud Labs, so spin up that Azure tenant, my friend. This is the easiest thing that you can do to gain hands-on experience, is spinning up your Azure tenant. So many people ask me about where to get cloud security skills, where to get cloud skills, where to learn about cloud computing. Spin up your tenant. The cloud provider that you are learning about, it's really important that you have your own environment and your own lab. Spin up your tenant. Use the free tier and the trial credits that you get. Deploy a virtual machine. Configure a storage account. And practice setting up firewalls or NSGs, network security groups. Add a VM with the virtual NIC with the public IP. And then try and exploit that. Do the scanning to show how vulnerable it is when your public IP is exposed. Spin up your tenant and start practicing. Then also experiment with Microsoft Defender for Cloud. So deploy a storage account and then use Defender for Cloud to remediate any vulnerabilities associated with your storage account. The real simple, real world experience that you can gain. The next part is to use Pwned Labs. Now, I've spoken about Pwned Labs. I have like a 44-minute roadmap together with Pwned Labs on this channel. But you can combine the labs that is available in Pwned Labs for cloud security with like that, to get like that CTF style skills to practice pen testing techniques on the cloud environment to make sure you know how to secure it. And then document the process as you go along. So I would here document what I did, how I did it. So I scanned for vulnerabilities using this type of tool. I eventually found this, and this is how I would secure it in the future. It is really, really important that you are able to document everything that you've learned in a structured, documented format, because this is what's going to help you. Like an employer finding your document repo or your screenshots of what you've completed, like you've set up MFA, you've done identity and access management, you set up your intra-ID tenant, created identities using a script, then disabled those identities, enabled multi-factor authentication on those identities, the purpose of why enabled multi-factor authentication, the risk of what happens if you don't. You need to have tangible proof. At this point, I would have tangible proof, right? Screenshots, write-ups, short video demos, showcasing real scenarios on Azure, capturing flags with Pwned Labs. This is what's going to really help me to stand out on LinkedIn or on GitHub at any given point in this journey. If there's one thing you remember from this video, is that skills trump certs every single time. So yes, employers like seeing well-known certifications, but what they really want to know is that you can fix issues. You can break into test environments. You can secure a cloud setup. Let your labs and your portfolio do the talking. At least this would be my core focus, would be my labs and my portfolio and me communicating with people that, hey, these are the skills I have. This is what I did today. This is how I did it. This is what you can do if you use the same storage account, if you use the same solution. This is a feature that you can use, which is really beneficial to your company. And this is how I would create visibility about myself to potential employers. Now is the time. In step 7, I would start applying for jobs. So here is exactly what I would target. The first thing is either IT support roles or sysadmin roles. So note here, I'm not targeting the help desk, right? I'm not at all targeting the help desk. I think with the skills that I have gained in the 6 months timeframe here, I can go directly to IT support or sysadmin. These roles would be great for building foundational troubleshooting skills. So many cybersecurity professionals start with like sysadmin or with IT support roles, and it's like a foot in the door, learning different processes in a corporate environment, and that gets you to move into security. The next one that I would target is like a junior or entry level SOC analyst. So security operations center analyst, right? So this role is really focused on defense, investigation, incident response, and it really be suitable for the skills that I've just learned. So the roles that I would look for here is like junior SOC analyst or security analyst level 1 or level 2, where you'll really be triaging alerts, investigating logs, and learning about real world threats. The next one could actually be, if you want to go offensive, this could be like a junior pen tester or a security consultant. So you target the offensive roles, highlighting your Pwned labs and CTF based experience. And here employers are really looking for that real world hands-on experience on how you would find, assess, and address vulnerabilities and reduce risks. So I already have this in my portfolio, so this would be great. And the final role I would target is a cloud security associate or cloud security analyst. So with the AZ900 or cloud practitioner, whichever one you went for, and then my SC200, I can now show that I know about cloud security, cloud security administration, working with the security tools inside of Azure. And here I would be showing off, of course, my Azure skills with my Azure labs, how I configured IAM policies, how I set up and secured VMs, etc. When you apply, or when I would apply for these jobs, I'm going to use a tailored resume for each of these scenarios that I'm targeting. So if I'm targeting sysadmin, I'm highlighting that experience. If I'm targeting cloud security analyst, I'm highlighting that experience with that lab-based content, because this just helps bring the employer's attention to what you're targeting as your first role, and it brings their attention in the first few seconds so that they go and look at your profile. It's very important that the profile and the resume that you use to apply for each of these different roles is very targeted to the company, to the role, to the job that you're applying to. And you guys, that is exactly how I would target my first 6 months on this journey. It's honestly with laser focus, doing some of these steps in parallel, like studying for AZ900 while practicing with Pwned labs. This is gonna save me time and help me gain traction to get certified and actually understand the concepts, right? So I hope you enjoyed that roadmap. I think it's super to the T. This is one that I think would definitely help those of you who are struggling with how exactly to go about this journey with laser focus. I think it would definitely help you out. Don't forget to check out Delete Me. And as always, let me know if this was helpful. Subscribe if you are new. Stay focused. Keep learning. Catch you next time. Bye.